Well, first of all, my immediate reaction is heartbreak. I've been in touch with Kayla's family. She was an outstanding young woman and a great spirit. And I think that spirit will live on. I think the more people learn about her, the more they appreciate what she stood for and how it stands in contrast with the barbaric organization that held her captive. But I don't think it's accurate, Ben, to say that the United States government hasn't done everything that we could. We devoted enormous resources and always devote enormous resources to freeing captives or hostages anywhere in the world. And, you know, I deployed an entire operation at significant risk to rescue not only her, but the other individuals that had been held, and probably missed them by a day or two, precisely because we have that commitment. The one thing that we have held to is a policy of not paying ransoms with an organization like ISIL. And the reason is that once we start doing that, not only are we financing their slaughter of innocent people, and strengthening their organization, but we're actually making Americans even greater targets for future kidnappings. It's as tough as anything that I do, having a conversation with parents who understandably want, by any means necessary, for their children to be safe. And we will do everything we can, short of providing an incentive for future Americans to be
called. Review underway. You're ruling out ransoms as anything even being considered there.
Yeah, just as a general rule, what we don't want to do is make other American citizens riper targets for the actions of organizations like this.